Let's discuss a very important subject. It's called markers. What are markers? Well, we look at the surface of the cancer cells that make up your breast cancer and look for estrogen receptor, progesterone receptor, and HER2-NU. If the cancer is estrogen and progesterone receptor positive, typically a patient needs an anti-hormone pill, such as tamoxifen, which has been around for many years, and the newer category called aromatase inhibitors. Now, the importance of the anti-hormone therapy is this. If you've had a lumpectomy, it helps to decrease the chance of the cancer coming back in the treated breast. If your other breast is still there, it has a preventative effect on the other breast that's significant. If your cancer is invasive and as cancer cells have circulated elsewhere in your body, we've known for well over 30 years, we have to treat the whole body. So anti-hormone pills are part of the adjuvant treatment of the whole body. Now, another marker that we look at is called HER2-NU. And this is an important marker that has led to the development of biologics in the Herceptin family. These are monoclonal antibody, big fancy term, directed targeted therapies that go after the cancer cells that are HER2-NU positive. This targeted therapy is not chemotherapy, but generally is given with chemotherapy. So the markers end up being very important. They're also important from a prognostic perspective. If, as an example, you are estrogen receptor negative, progesterone receptor negative, and HER2-NU negative, that's called triple negative, which is a category of more aggressive kinds of breast cancer. The HER2-NU positive breast cancers are also tend to be more aggressive, but again, we have targeted therapies for them. It is vitally important that you know all about your tumor, that you know the markers, because the result of the markers impacts dramatically and significantly your overall treatment.